Welcome back to this component of the course where you're going to get some practical experience of using Docker Compose. And Docker Compose is a way to create and manage multi-container applications. Now it works using a YAML configuration file which can be called compose.yaml or docker-compose.yaml. Now generally Docker Compose is part of a multi-step process. First you define each of your container images using a Docker file, which you've done earlier in the course. You push those container images to a repository, which you're going to be doing later in the course. You define a Docker Compose file and then use that file using the Docker Compose command. Now, inside the text-based instructions for this component of the course is a Docker Compose file. What I want you to do is to copy all of that into your clipboard and then paste it in to your favorite text editor. Now select all of that text and there should be a way to convert tabs to spaces. This is really essential because YAML files can't have tabs inside. In the case of this editor, I can click on Editor and then convert tabs to spaces. And there we go, this is a Docker Compose file. Now this Docker Compose file, under services, defines two containers. We've got the DB container and the WordPress container. And as you've guessed it, this is a multi-container deployment of WordPress. WordPress requires the application part and the database part. So the application part is defined within this container and the database part is defined within this container. Additionally, it defines two named volumes at the bottom, MariaDB underscore data and WordPress underscore data. And these are used within both of these containers. So we can see here we're using WordPress underscore data, so the named volume defined here, and this is being mapped inside the WordPress container to this folder. Likewise, the MariaDB named volume, if we scroll up to the top, is being used within the database container, and this is mapped to the folder where the MariaDB data files are stored inside that container. Now, what I want you to do is to go ahead and save this into a folder on your local machine. I suggest your home folder where we were running the commands in the previous demo component. So I'm going to go ahead and click File and then Save As. I'm going to go to my home folder and I'm going to save this file as compose.yaml and then press Save. Then I'm going to go to my terminal, make sure I'm in my home folder and clear the screen. And to use that compose.yaml file, we need to run a docker space compose space up space hyphen D. Now, if I don't specify anything else on this command line, it's going to look for that Docker Compose file using one of its default valid names, and compose.yaml is one of those names. Now, the up option here is going to tell Docker Compose to bring up the things defined in that file. So this will have the effect of running containers and creating any named volumes. The hyphen D option is going to run this detached, so it's going to run it in the background. This works in the same way as when you've used the hyphen D option earlier in the course. So let's go ahead and run that command. And you can see that it begins by pulling the WordPress image because we don't have that stored locally. So it's going to download all of the file system layers which form the WordPress image. From earlier in the course, I already have a local stored copy of the MariaDB image, and so it's going to use that local image. And then it's going to create two named volumes, MariaDB underscore data and WordPress underscore data. And in this case, it's prefixing the volumes which it creates and the containers which it creates with my username, which is acantril. So now all of this is running. If I run a docker space ps and press enter, we can see that we've got these two containers running, the WordPress container and the database container. If we're on a docker space volume space ls, likewise we've got two named volumes which have been created by the docker compose command. So now let's open our web browser and go to http://. localhost :8081 and press enter. And what you should see is the WordPress installation screen. So this is running inside the WordPress container. And if we go back to our text editor, we can see this because we're using this ports directive here to map port 80 of this container to port 8081 on our Docker host. And that's why we can access it using port 8081 in our web browser. Now we're going to have to choose the language that we want WordPress to use, so select the language and click on continue. Then it's going to ask for a site title. I'm going to use all the cats and you can do the same. For username, go ahead and put admin. And then for the password, leave the default generated strong password. All that I want you to do is to copy this into your clipboard and note it down somewhere safe. You'll also need to enter your email. So I'll go ahead and enter mine. You should enter your own email, scroll down to the bottom and click Install WordPress. Once the install's complete, click on Login, enter admin for username, enter the strong password that you just copied down and click on Login. After a few moments, it should log you in and the WordPress installation should be fully functional. So now we're going to go ahead and just create a test post. So click on Posts and then Add New. Click on the plus sign here and then go to gallery. We're going to add a gallery. Click on upload and then go ahead and select some images. If you don't have any images on your local machine, you can just go ahead and go to Google Images, download a few cat images and then upload these to this gallery. In my case, I'm going to be inclusive. I'm going to pick a cat, a dog and a different type of cat. I'm going to give the post a nice title, so two cats and a dog, then click publish and publish again. And once that's done, click on View Post. So this has now stored some data, different types of data, on the WordPress container and the database container. On the WordPress container, it's stored these actual images, whereas on the database container, it's stored the metadata and information about this post, and both are required for this post and WordPress to be fully functional. So now we're going to demonstrate how the data that we've stored in both of these containers can now live on past the life cycle of the containers, and we're going to demonstrate that using the multi-container management functionality provided by Docker Compose. So let's go back to our terminal, and we're just going to clear the screen to make it easy to see. If we run a Docker space PS, we can see that we've got two running containers, WordPress and the database. Now, still within that folder where we have our compose.yaml file, I'm going to go ahead and run a Docker space compose space down and press enter. And that's going to stop and remove any of the containers defined within this compose.yaml file. So it's going to remove the database container and it's going to remove the WordPress container. If we just clear the screen and run a Docker space PS, we can see that we've got no running containers. If we run a Docker space PS space hyphen A and press enter, we can see that we've got no stopped containers. These have been completely removed. However, if we run a Docker space volume space ls and press enter, it hasn't deleted these named volumes. And remember, these named volumes are actually storing the WordPress data and the data from MariaDB. And if we create new containers and set them to use these named volumes, they'll use the data within these named volumes, which should contain the post that we just created. So let's test that. If we run a Docker space compose space up space hyphen D, it's going to recreate both the WordPress and the database containers. Now, because we already have the Docker images for these stored locally, this should be pretty fast. And in addition, it will utilize the existing named volumes. It won't create new ones. So let's go ahead and run that command. We can see that it's created both of the containers, it's created the network, and it's going to reuse those existing named volumes. So now if we go back to the web browser and just hit refresh, we should see the existing post continues to work with no problems. We can open each of these images in new tabs and see that we directed to the original images that are stored within the WordPress container. Now again, this is all possible because we've used named volumes. So these are volumes which persist past the lifetime of the existing containers. Even though we use the Docker compose down command to delete those containers, when we recreated those containers, it used the existing named volumes, which contained the database data and the WordPress data. So this is the metadata of the post and the image data. So that data persisted past the lifetime of any individual container, and it was reused when we ran new containers using Docker Compose. So I hope this demonstrates both the power of named volumes again, but also how easy it is to manage multi-container applications using Docker Compose and compose.yaml files. So it's really powerful. You can use Docker Compose files to define containers, which images are used, any commands to run, any named volumes. You can specify environment variables, how containers respond to container host restarts. You can also define links between different containers. And you can manage applications which consist of multiple containers easily using Docker Compose. Now that's all you need to know at an introductory level. What we need to do now is to clean up all of the resources that we've used within this demo component of the course, and we'll do that using Docker space compose space down. Again, this will delete those containers and the network that the containers use. We'll need to delete the volumes manually though, so if we run a Docker space volume space ls, we'll be able to see the names of the volumes. And then we'll need to run a Docker space volume space rm, and then one of the volume names, and then again Docker space volume space rm, and then the name of the other named volume. So in this case, my username underscore WordPress underscore data. At this point, what we should be able to do, just to confirm everything has been deleted, I'll clear the screen, and then run a Docker space ps space hyphen a. We've got no running or stopped containers. Then Docker space volume space ls, and we've got none of those named volumes that we created during this demo component of the course. At this point, that is everything I wanted to cover practically about Docker Compose and Docker named volumes using Docker Compose. So go ahead, and when you're ready, you can move on to the next part of the course.